So in last class, what we have seen is various types of force systems that we may encounter in real life problems, and those systems were coplanar and space force system, and in those we have categorization or bifurcation as concurrent or non-concurrent force system. Vijay, do you remember that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you read this? I'm going to demonstrate resultant in case of all those four systems, but through numerical examples, as I said in the last class. So can you read this problem for me? Problem number 11.
Truss supports the loadings shown. A, determine resultant at B, determine the equivalent force acting on the truss and the point of intersection of its lines of action with a line drawn through point A and G.
Yes. So in a book, in unsolved problems, only part B was mentioned, but I have added part A so that we understand resultant in greater depth. So let us begin. So you have been given a structure. This structure is called as truss. We are going to learn truss separately. So what is a truss? We will see that later. But you see these members which are marked shaded in blue color. Those are members of the truss. And the truss is acted upon by an external load, external loads 240 pound, 160 pound, 300 pound, and 180 pound. Are you with me, Vijay? Vijay, are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Now let us try to solve the first part of this. We have to determine the resultant of all these forces at point E. So as I had mentioned, a class before, we already know what is resultant. If I were to replace all these forces by something at E which produces exactly the same effect as this system of forces on all points of this truss, then we are going to call it as resultant of this force system. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Yes. So I have to replace all these forces by something at E which produces exactly the same effect as all these forces were producing on all points on this truss. That is my aim. Now, let us first characterize what kind of force system it is. So what can you say? Is it a coplanar force system or is it a space force system? Yes, Vijay.
It is coplanar.
Yes, because lines of actions of all the forces under consideration, they are in a single plane, and therefore I am going to call this force system as coplanar force system. Lines of actions of all the forces are in one plane. So now let me define that plane. So to define that plane, I choose to call this axis as X, and perpendicular to this axis as Y. Coming out of the plane of board is Z. So therefore, this is a coplanar force system in XY plane. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
In XY plane. So lines of actions of all the forces, they do lie in XY plane. That's what I mean. Now, is it a concurrent force system or is it a non-concurrent force system?
It is non-concurrent.
Yes.
Non-concurrent force.
Yes, correct. Because if you choose this 240 pound force and 300 pound force, their lines of actions, they will intersect somewhere outside the truss. But the line of action of 180 pound force and 160 pound force is definitely not passing through that point of intersection. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, we know lines of actions of all the forces, they do not converge in a single point, or they do not intersect in a single point. Yes, go ahead. So therefore, this is non-concurrent force system. Non-concurrent force system. So what is the categorization? Categorization of this force system is, it is coplanar but non-concurrent. And what are we supposed to do? I have to reduce this force system to its resultant at E. So we are going to now have a look at it. What are the characteristics of resultant of coplanar and non-concurrent force system at a specified point? Pehla jo part hai uska narrative dekho. We have to find out resultant at E. So we have been given a point, and we have to replace all these forces by something which produces exactly the same effect on the body. and we are dealing with coplanar and non-concurrent forces. So let us have a look at characterization of resultant at a point. Now, if I consider this point E, and if I start asking the question, what is the effect of this 240 pound force acting at B at E? So, kya karna padega? We have already seen that if the force is acting at any other point, I have to take force as it is at E, and plus you are going to have a moment. Do you agree with me, Vijay?
Yes, sir.
So, if what is the effect of this 240 pound force at E? That 240 pound force as it is plus moment. Similarly, what is the effect of this 160 pound force at E? That 164 pound force as it is plus some moment. This 300 pound force, what is its effect at E? That 300 pound force as it is plus some moment. And 180 pound force acting at C, what is its effect at E? So I have to take 180 pound force as it is plus its moment. Are you with me, Vijay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so therefore we will calculate moments of all these forces at E separately, but first of all, let me transfer all these forces at point E. So if I transfer all the forces at E, I see a diagram something like this. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, question is, can I reduce all these forces shown at E to a single entity? Yes, easily, by the concept of resolution. Do you agree with me? So I am going to use rectangular resolution of these forces. I am going to call this axis as X. I am going to call this axis as Y. So if I were to replace all these forces by a single force, then what is the X component of that force? So X component of that force, that single force, I am going to call it as Rx, and its X component is summation Fx. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us try to do summation fx. So summation fx kaise do? Just give me a second. So how do I write summation fx? Bolo. Let us start with 240 pound force. What is the x component of 240 pound force? Tell me.
240 cos 70, sir.
240
cos 70.
Correct. Jiske beech mein theta, wo component cos theta. And it is towards positive x. So it is plus 240 cos 70. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is the x component of 160 pound force? Yes.
Zero.
Zero. Because it is 160 cos of 90. Cos of 90 is zero. Angle made by 160 pound force with x axis is 90 degree. Therefore, its x component is going to be 160 cos of 90. Cos of 90 is 0. So therefore, 160 pound force does not produce any component along x. Now, what is the x component of 300 pound force?
Minus 300
cos 40.
Yes. So it is minus because it is towards negative x axis, and it is 300 cos of 40. Jiske beech mein theta, wo component cos theta. Great. Now, what is the x component of 180 pound force?
Zero, sir.
Because it is acting at an angle 90 degree with the x axis. Therefore, its x component will be 180 cos 90, that is zero. So we know that x component of resultant of all these forces is going to be 240 cos 70 minus 300 cos 40. Ensure that your calculators are in degree mode and please calculate this. I will also do this with you. Meanwhile, all the students who have joined late, for them, all the lecture recordings are made available on YouTube except last lecture. I will upload that lecture and today's lecture today itself. So they should refer that YouTube, my YouTube channel, and they should go through all the lecture recordings. So let us do this calculation. 240 cos of 70 minus 300 cos of 40. So how much did you get? I got it as minus 147.72. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it is minus 147.72 pounds And as it is negative, therefore it must be directed towards negative x-axis. Do you agree with me? Vijay, are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Vijay, are you attending the classes from the first class or have you recently joined the division?
Yes, sir. I am attending the from second or third lecture.
Okay. So you are understanding all this, right? I believe.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us write down the y component of resultant or y component of addition of all these forces. If I were to replace all these forces by a single force, I will have to find out our x component of that single force, y component of that single force, then I can find out the single force magnitude and direction. So what is ry? So how do I find out ry? It is by summation of y components of all the forces. So can you quickly tell me the y components of all forces? What will be the y component of 240 pound force?
240 sine 70.
Sine 70.
Plus or minus?
Minus.
Minus. So minus 240 sine 70. Sine 70. Why minus? Because you can see that only if downward force and towards right force, these two forces are added, then only we can get 240 in this quadrant. So therefore its y component must be in the downward direction. So it is 240 sine 70. Now what is the y component of 164 pound force?
Minus 160.
Yes, because the angle made by this force with y axis is 0 and we want the y component. So it is 160 cos 0. Cos 0 is 1. So therefore it is minus 160 because it is acting in negative y direction. Do you agree with me, Vijay?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Let us go ahead. What is the y component of 300 pound force?
Minus 300 sine 40.
Yes. So minus 300 sine 40. जिसके बीच में थीटा वो कंपोनेंट कॉस थीटा. सो एज थीटा इज दैट एज 40 डिग्री इज बिटवीन हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड 300 पाउंड फोर्स, द हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट विल बी कॉस एंड वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट विल बी साइन. सो एंड व्हाट इज द कंपोनेंट ऑफ दिस 180 पाउंड फोर्स इन वाई डायरेक्शन?
माइनस 180.
सो व्हाट इज समेशन आर वाई? Summation ry will be given by this expression. So let us calculate that. Minus 240 sine 70, minus 160, minus 300 sine 40, minus 180. So how much did you get? I got it as minus 758.36. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So minus 758.36. pounds, and as it is negative, therefore it is acting in negative y direction. So this is ry. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now how do we find out rx? So rx to how do we find out magnitude of r? So if I were to replace all these forces by single force r bar, its magnitude will be equal to square root of rx square plus ry square. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us do that. Summation of rx square root of rx square plus ry square. We know rx and ry. Sign doesn't matter because square is sitting there. So square root of in bracket 147.72 square plus 758.36 square. So I got it as 772.613. Is that right? Is it right? Somebody please confirm.
Yes, sir, it's correct.
Okay. So therefore R is equal to 772.613. But that's not enough. I also must know its direction. So direction kaun sa hai wo agar hume dekhna hai. So what I will have to do is I will have to find out the angle made by the resultant. So angle between resultant and x-axis. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
How much is that? That is tan inverse of ry upon Rx, but this is to be done without considering the sign, mind you. So it is absolute of Ry upon absolute of Rx. So without considering the sign, you are going to take this tan inverse. So shift tan inverse of 758.36 divided by 147.72. So I got it as 78.97 degree. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
So it is 78.97 degree. And how do we decide the quadrant of this R? So uske liye ab sign consider karna padega. So dekho, Rx is negative. So Rx is this way. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Ry is negative. So Ry is this way. So what will be the quadrant? Quadrant is going to be this one. So this is going to be the R. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what is the angle made by R with x axis that we have calculated? That is 78.97 degrees. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what is its magnitude? Its magnitude is 772.613 pound. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So till now, what we have done is, if I were to replace this force system by something at E, I know what one of the part of that something. What is that something? I have to transfer all the forces at E, and then I have to replace them by a single force. So that is this single force. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But there is something missing. And what is that missing part? I have not calculated moments of all the forces. When I find the effect of 160 pound at E, I have to take this 160 pound force as it is. Plus, I have to also consider the moment. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So similar thing is true for even 240 pound, 300 pound and 180 pound force. So humne ek force to nikal liya jo hume E pe apply karna hai, so that force will have same effect as all these forces on all parts of the body. But we have not yet considered the moments of all these forces. So we need to now consider moments. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So moment consider karne hai, toh what is the procedure that we follow? We resolve all the forces along x and y, rectangular components, and then we take their moments about E. Are you with me? E ke yahan pe hume resultant find out karna hai. So we are going to take moments of all the forces at E. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So that's what I am going to do now. 240 pound force, iska x component towards right, y components down. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
300 pound force, x component towards left, y component down. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
160 pound force, x component 0, y component is 160 pound itself. 180 pound force, x component 0, 180 pound itself is a y component. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now I have maintained a color code. We will use that color code. Just give me a second. So let us show this 160 pound force in black, and let us show this 180 pound force in yellow. Are you with me? Vijay, are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we have now color code for each of the forces. So the first color, let me find out the x component of this 240 pound force. So x component of this 240 pound force, how much it is? 240 cos 70. Now don't write it as negative, because we have already shown the sense, and don't write it as positive or negative, because we have already shown the sense. So we are going to write down only magnitude of that. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now imagine that no other force is prevalent on the body. Only this 240 cos 70 is prevalent, and we are holding the body at E. What kind of moment does it produce about E? Clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Clockwise.
So I am going to show that moment as clockwise. So there is a correlation. Color code is followed for understanding. This component, this kind of moment. And how much is that moment? When we are dealing with horizontal force, we are looking at vertical distances. So what is the vertical distance of point E from 240 cos 70? It is 6 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So now, what I am going to write is moment of all the forces at E. How do I write? And it is about Z axis passing through E. So, kaise likhu? Bolo. 240 cos 70. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This multiplied by 6 feet. Do you agree with me? Its distance from vertical distance from E is 6 feet. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And as it is clockwise, now I am not bothered about the sign of the component as such. I am bothered about what is the nature of moment produced about E. That component produces a clockwise moment about E. So even though the component is positive, this moment will be given negative sign. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Because we treat clockwise moments as negative. And what is the unit? So this force is in pound, this is in feet. So the unit will be pound feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us consider the vertical component of this 240 pound force. Vertical component is how much? Tell me. 240. Kya likhu?
Sine
70. And don't now mention it to be negative. We have shown its direction downward. So it is understood that it is in negative y direction. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
If I write it as negative, negation of negation becomes assertion. Negative force in downward direction means upward force. So therefore, be very careful while writing down the signs. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it is 240 sine 70. What kind of moment does it produce at E? Imagine that all other forces are vanished. And only all other forces are not there. And only this 240 sine 70 is there. And you are holding the body at E. What kind of moment does it produce about E?
Anticlockwise.
Anticlockwise. So I have shown this moment anticlockwise. And what is the moment component? As I am dealing with vertical force, I will be looking at horizontal distance between E and B. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the horizontal distance between E and B? So dekho, 8 plus 8, 16 feet is the distance between A and E. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And A or B ke beech mein distance kitna hai? What horizontal distance? 4 feet. So what is the horizontal distance between B and E? It is 16 minus 4. So it is 12 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, what is this moment? 240 sine 70 into 12. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So 240 sine 70 multiplied by 12. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And it is positive because it is anti-clockwise. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let us come to this 160 pound force. 160 pound force, what kind of moment does it produce about E? Anti-clockwise or clockwise? Anti-clockwise. So I am going to show this as anti-clockwise moment. And what is the moment? 160 multiplied by the horizontal distance between D and E. What is horizontal distance between D and E? How do I get that?
4 feet.
Yes. Yes. So looking at the symmetry, you can understand that the distance between D and E is 4. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Agar aap geometry, hamesha geometry solve karke dikhane ki zarurat nahi hai. You are very sure that all these triangles are equilateral triangles. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Isosceles, if not equilateral, that can be seen. And then you can say that if I drop, means the vertical distance between E and D has to be 4 feet. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So it is 160 into 4 and it is positive because it is anti-clockwise. While writing the sign here, I am looking at the nature of the moment and not nature of the component. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is 160 multiplied by 4. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let us go ahead now. the next force, 300 pound force. Let us look at its x component. How much is its x component? 300.
Cos 40, sir.
Cos 40. What kind of moment does it produce about E?
Anticlockwise.
Anticlockwise. So can I write down this component also as positive? Yes. And what is that component? 300 cos 40. Horizontal force, vertical distance. 300 cos 40 into 6. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Dekho, 300 cos 40 component as such is in negative x direction. But when I write down the sign in moment term, that should be dependent upon the nature of moment. So as the nature of moment by this component about E is anticlockwise, I am going to write down the plus sign. Plus 300 cos 40 into 6. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So plus 300 cos 40 into 6. Now, let us look at the vertical component. How much is the vertical component of this 300 pound force? 300 sine 40. What kind of moment does it cause about E?
Clockwise.
So this moment now is clockwise. So what sign should I give?
Negative.
And how much is that moment? 300 sine 40 into 4. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me write down minus 300 sine 40 into 4. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Now, only one force is pending now, that 180 pound force. What kind of moment does it cause? About E. Anticlockwise. Yes, so this moment is shown anticlockwise. Can I write down the magnitude 180 multiplied by 8 feet? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so plus 180 into 8. 180 into 8. Are you able to see my screen clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us try to find out how much is this. So do that and let me know.
4901.34.
Okay, so I will need an independent confirmation. So aur koi batao sahi hai ki nahi, and then we will go ahead. I will also do it with you. Minus 240 cos of 70 into 6 plus 240 into sine 70 into 12 plus 160 into 4 plus 300 cos 40 multiplied by 6 minus 300 sine 40 multiplied by 4 plus 180 into 8. 4901 chalo jisne bataya tha wo confirm karo. 4901.34. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
4901.34. And what is the unit? Unit is pound feet. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have calculated the moment. And has it turned out to be positive or negative? It has turned out to be positive. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So positive ka matlab kya hai? Therefore, it must be anticlockwise. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So if I were to replace all these forces by their resultant at E, what will be that resultant? So that I am going to write down now. So what is resultant at E? Resultant at E. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Resultant at E has two parts. One part is the force. What is the force? 772.613 newton. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
772.613, not newton, pounds, and which makes an angle of how much? 78.97 degree. 78.97 97 degree with the horizontal, and this is E. And in addition to that, it's not sufficient. If I replace all these forces by only this force at E, it is not going to produce exactly the same effect on all points of body, unless I also apply a moment of 4901.34 pound feet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So 4901.34 pound feet, anti-clockwise image. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So this is the answer. So what is take home message? So if you have a coplanar but non-concurrent force system, you are going to have two parts to the resultant in general at a point. You are finding out a result, finding out resultant at a point. Are you with me? So at a point, coplanar and non-concurrent force system will generally have two components. One, force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And another, moment. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what does it mean? If I remove all the forces acting on a body and replace it by this force couple system, isko hum bolte hai force couple system. Kya kahenge? Force couple system. If I replace it by this force couple system, this force couple system is going to have exactly the same effect as the system of forces which were already there on all points of the truss. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, before we go to the second part of this question, let me ask you another question. Can I find out some point in this space where I could reduce all these forces to a single force resultant without any movement? Question samajh mein aaya? Vijay, are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Dekho, abhi hume kya bola gaya tha? Find out resultant of this force system at point E. That point E was given to you. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Ab main aapko dusra question pooch raha hu. Can I have some point on the body or off the body such that if I find out resultant of all those forces at that point, it will have only single force resultant and moment will be zero. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Kya aisa point hum find out kar sakte? The answer to that question is yes, we can find out, and that precisely is the part B. So can you read the part B of the question once again?
Determine the equivalent force acting on the truss and the point of intersection of its line of action with a line drawn through point A and G.
Yes. So are you able to, now let me borrow this diagram down. Let me explain this question to you, part B to you. So now what is being asked? They want you to do a thought experiment where you are going to extend this line AG, are you with me, infinitely on both sides. Happy? And they are asking you to find out a point on this line AG somewhere here. I have shown it somewhere here, such that if I try to find out resultant of all these forces at this point, it will be only a force resultant accompanied by no moment. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Aise wala point hume find out karna hai. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So how do we go about that? So how are we going to do that? So therefore, ab dekho main kya karne wala hu. Let me call this point as ki kaha tak use kiya humne? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. H nahi use kiya na? Okay, so let me call this point as H. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the description of point H? H is a point. H is a point on line AG. Jo question mein pucha hai hame. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Such that resultant of 240 pound 160 pound 300 pound and 180 pound force at H is single force resultant. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
इसका मतलब क्या है? It is not a force coupled system. It is single force resultant. इसका ही दूसरा मतलब है कि moment of all the forces at H vanishes. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Resultant. इसका ही दूसरा मतलब ये है कि मोमेंट ऑफ ऑल द फोर्सेस एट एच इज जीरो. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
सो आई एम डिक्टेटिंग कंडीशंस ऑन एच. सो इफ आई वर आस्क्ड टू रिप्लेस दिस फोर्स सिस्टम बाय अ सिंगल फोर्स बाय समथिंग बाय इट्स रिजल्टेंट एट एच, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन? H is such a point where I will be able to reduce all these forces to R, which we have already found out. R mein to change nahi hoga because I am going to put all the forces at H instead of E. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So is summation Fx going to change? No. Is summation Fy going to change? No. So is Rx going to change? No. Ry going to change? No. R magnitude wise will not change. And its line of actions orientation with reference to x also will not change. So I will be able to replace all this force system by R here, which is 772.613. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Pounds. And it is making an angle of 78.97 degrees with x-axis. It lies in this quadrant. And accompanied moment will be zero. M is zero. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
ऐसे वाला H point हमें find out करना है. और कहाँ पे find out करना है? Along line AG. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now there are three possibilities. This point may lie on right hand side of G. It may lie somewhere between A and G, or it may lie on left hand side of A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So without loss of generality, I will assume that it lies on the right hand side of G for my convenience. Assume kiya. Are you with me?
Okay, sir.
Isko jaise ye assume kiya and then I started calling A as origin. You can also call G as origin. No point, no issues. But I called A as origin. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then distance of this H on along line AG, I am going to call that as X. Are you with me? And what do we need to find out? We need to find out how much is that X. So where should this H lie on line AG such that these conditions which I am demanding are satisfied? Are you with me? Chalo. I understand that many of you have understood the concept, but still, as this is the crucial point, I would like to go slow. So once again, let us read statement B. Determine the equivalent force acting on a truss and the point of intersection of its line of action with a line drawn along A and G. Iska hi dusra matlab ye hai ki hume aise find out karna hai along line AG, where should I take a point such that this force system will reduce to only single force resultant without any moment. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, jo problem statement ka meaning hai, wo maine yahan pe draw karke dikha diya. Now, our job is to find out X. Happy?
Yes, sir.
How would you find out X? Answer is easy. What do I have to do? I have to take summation of moments of all the forces at H and then I have to equate it to zero. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So how do I do that? So this is equal to. So again, I am going to resolve the forces. I have resolved this force in two components. Chalo, ek ek karte jaate hai. So that we get a grasp on this. Can you tell me what is the horizontal component of 240 pound force? We have done that. I will rewrite it again. 240 cos 70. Do you agree with me? What kind of moment does it produce about H? What kind of moment does it produce about H? Clockwise. So therefore it is negative. So I will write it as minus 240 cos of 70 multiplied by. Now tell me, what is the vertical distance between 240 cos 70 and H? It is 6 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Because force AG, because H lies on line AG, therefore it is this multiplied by 6. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now quickly, what is the vertical component of this force? 240 sine 70. What kind of moment does it produce about H?
Anti-clockwise.
So it is going to be positive. And what is the distance? Bolo. 240 sine 70, isn't it x minus 4?
Yes, sir.
Dekho, ye distance hai x, usme se 4 kaat do. So x minus 4 is going to be the distance of this 240 sine 70 from H. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So I will write 240 sine 70. 240 sine 70 multiplied by x minus 4. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, 160 pound force. 160 pound force, what kind of moment does it produce? What kind of moment does it produce?
Anticlockwise.
About H, anticlockwise. Right. So plus or minus? Plus. And what should I write? 160. What is the distance? This distance is x. Usme se 8 plus 4, 12 kaat do. So x minus 12. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So plus 160 into x minus 12. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now 300 pound. What is its horizontal component?
300 cos 40.
300 cos 40. What kind of moment does it cause about H?
Anticlockwise.
Yes. So it is positive. Do you agree with me? So plus.
Yes, sir.
300 cos of 40 multiplied by. Bolo. Distance kya hai? 6 feet. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So multiplied by 6. Fine. Then which color did we use for vertical component? Green one. So let me mark that. Bolo. 300
sine 40.
Sine 40. What kind of moment does it cause about H?
Anticlockwise.
So 300 sine 40. Kitna distance? Horizontal distance between F and H. Total distance from A is X. Usme se 4 plus 8 plus 8. So 20 feet kaat do. So x minus 20. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So 300 sine 40 into x minus 20 anti-clockwise or clockwise?
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise. So plus 300 sine 40 into x minus 20. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, aage. 180 pound force. What kind of moment does it cause? Anticlockwise? Yes. So positive?
Yes.
Achha, ye 300 sine 40 ka humne minus Q liya tha. That was because it was about point E. And now we are talking about point H. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So we are on the right track. So now 180 multiplied by how much? Total distance is x. Usme se 8 kaat do. So 180 into x minus 8. So plus 180 into x minus 8. This is to be equated to 0. The only unknown in this equation is x. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So you have to solve for x. How do you do that? So you can do that on calculator. So those who know how to do it on calculator using shift solve function, they can proceed with that and give me the confirmation. I am going to solve it for you. Jinko pata nahi hai ki ye equation calculator pe without simplification kaise solve kare, unke liye I am going to upload a video, 2 minutes video on how to solve for a linear equation in x on calculator. Are you with me?
ओके सर.
ओके सो राइट नाउ जिनको पता है कैसे सॉल्व करें वो एक्स के लिए सॉल्व करो एंड देन बताओ मुझे. आई विल आल्सो सॉल्व विद यू. सो -240 cos 70 into 6 -240 sin 70 into in bracket alpha x -4 bracket complete plus 160 into bracket alpha x minus 12 bracket complete plus 300 cos of 40 multiplied
yes,
by 6 plus 300 sine of 40 multiplied by alpha x minus 20 bracket complete plus 180 multiplied by bracket me alpha x minus 8 alpha equal to 0 shift solve. So I got x as 17.66 meter. Has anyone got that? ओके जिनको पता नहीं है कैसे सॉल्व करना उनको मैं दूसरा टास्क देता हूं. जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट 17.663 इंस्टेड ऑफ एक्स हियर एंड चेक दैट यू आर गेटिंग जीरो एज ए आंसर. ओके
ओके सर.
जस्ट डू दैट. जिनको पता है कैसे कैलकुलेट कैसे सॉल्व करना है वो सॉल्व करके मुझे कंफर्म करो कि एक्स का आंसर 17.663 है. Any confirmation will do. Even if you put x equal to 17.663 in the equation and show that it is 0, that also indicates the answer is correct. So I will pause the recording till you confirm. Okay, so I leave it to you to cross verify if it is correct 17.663, but let us interpret the answer. I have resumed the recording. So what is the distance between A and G? Distance between A and G is 8 plus 8 plus 8, 24 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So now, when distance between A and G is 24 feet, but this value has turned out to be 17.663. So therefore, that point H is going to be somewhere between A and G. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And now, therefore, the senses of moments of components of 300-pound force and possibly 160-pound force will be not 160 pound force, only 300 pound force will be opposite, but that is self adjusting because if you look at the expression of components of 300 sin 40 x minus 20, the moment I substitute x equal to 17.663, it becomes negative and automatically the sign reverses. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, don't worry about the signs that we have given. We have assumed that H lies on the right hand side of G and accordingly we have given the signs of moments, but when X turns out to be in between A and G, those signs are self-adjusting. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the take-home message? So dekho yahan pe do tarike ke resultant find out kiye in this problem. Whenever a system has a coplanar, whenever the force system is coplanar and non-concurrent, if you are asked to find out resultant of that system at a point, then in 99% cases you will end up with having two quantities. One is force and another is moment. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
However, there are certain points in the space which may lie on the body or outside the body where the resultant will reduce to a single force resultant. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
सिर्फ सिंगल फोर्स रिजल्टेंट को वो रिड्यूस होगा, उस वहां पे कोई भी मोमेंट नहीं होगा. सो गिवन ए पॉइंट जहां पे आपको फोर्स सिस्टम का रिजल्टेंट निकालना है, पॉसिबिलिटी दैट यू विल एंड अप हैविंग टू कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ रिजल्टेंट, वन इज फोर्स एंड अनदर इज मोमेंट. हाउएवर व्हेन यू हैव बीन आस्क्ड टू फाइंड आउट रिजल्टेंट ऑफ दिस फोर्स सिस्टम विदाउट स्पेसिफाइंग ए पॉइंट, दैट मींस यू हैव टू लोकेट द पॉइंट ऑफ एप्लीकेशन ऑफ रिजल्टेंट वेयर द मोमेंट ऑफ ऑल द फोर्सेस they nullify or they vanish. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So having said that, this point will be more clear. It will be clarified in a better way in the next problem. So we are not going to solve the next problem in today's class, but at least we are going to discuss the idea. So can you read the problem statement for me?
A machine component is subjected to the forces and couples shown. The component is to be held in the place by a single rivet that can resist a force but not a couple. For p equals 0, determine the location of the rivet hole if it is to be located fg or on th.
Yes, so rivet is something like bolt. So you are allowed to have one bolt or a nail on either on line fg or on line gh. Kahi to aapko ek nail और एक बोल्ट प्लेस करना है. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
सच दैट ऑल दिस फोर्सेस डू नॉट प्रोड्यूस एनी मूवमेंट ऑफ द बॉडी इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ दैट नेल. हैप्पी?
यस सर.
नाउ टेल मी, इफ आई ट्राई टू रोटेट दिस बॉडी अबाउट दिस बोल्ट, इज इट इजीली पॉसिबल? यस, बिकॉज नेल कैन रेजिस्ट ओनली फोर्सेस. आई कैन रोटेट द बॉडी फ्रीली अबाउट दिस. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
Now, so rotation is the effect of what? Moment or a force? Rotation kiska effect? No, rotation kiska effect hai? Is it effect of force or is it effect of moment?
Moment.
Moment ka effect hai. So the moment they say that you are going to have only single rivet, it has been implicitly said that find out the position along FG such that all these forces have only single force resultant without any moment. Because if there is a moment, the body will rotate about the nail or rivet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So explicitly bola gaya hai ki aap line FG pe ya phir line GH pe aisa location dhundo jahan pe in sare forces ka resultant sirf single force aata hai, moment nahi aata. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
That is what is being asked. So we are going to solve this problem tomorrow. So in fact, even though these problems are two problems, only two problems, 11 and 12, they have two parts each. So it is as if we are solving four problems. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
We will complete this problem number 12 in the next class, and then we will march ahead with something called as equilibrium. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So equilibrium and Varignon's theorem is next in line. We will stop here today. You can put your attendance in the attendance link. For new students, I request somebody to reshare that attendance link on our WhatsApp group. So let us close it here. If anyone has any doubt, you can ask me.